The fourth part is you have to convert this decimal into fractions. Now please pay attention on these decimals. These decimals are having a bar on their digits. The bar represents that these digits are getting repeated. So what we do for these? Let us write x equal to 0.6 bar. Now this bar is representing that 6 is repeating infinite number of times. That means this can be written as 0.6666 and so on, infinite number of times. Now how many digits were repeating? 1. So we multiply both the sides with 10. Why 10? Because only one digit was repeating. If two digits are repeating, we multiply both the sides with 100. If three digits are repeating, we multiply both the sides with 1000 and so on. So because one digit was repeating, I multiply both the sides with 10. What do I get? 10x equal to, and if you multiply this with 10, you get 6.6666 and so on. Now this is my first equation, this is my second equation. Now you have to subtract the second equation or from the second equation the first equation. On subtraction you would see that you get 10x minus x equal to 6.666 so on minus 0.666 so on, and we get 9x on the left hand side. On the right hand side we get 6. So where now x is coming out to be 6 upon 9. Solving this further by taking out the factors common, we get 2 upon 3. So 2 upon 3 is the fraction for this decimal. Similarly, the last part is having 0.48 bar. Now the bar is on two digits. So how do we represent it? X is equal to 0.484848 going on. Now, because two digits are repeating, we will multiply both the sides with 100. So multiply with 100 and we get 100x equal to 48.484848 and so on. So this is the first equation that we had, and this has become our second equation. On subtracting both, that is subtracting the first equation from the second one, we would get 100x minus x, that would be equal to 48.4848 so on, minus the right hand side, that was 0.4848 and so on. So on the left hand side we get 99x equal to 48 minus 48.48 and so on minus 0.48, that is 48 only. Now x comes out to be 48 upon 99. If possible, you can solve it further. Yes, we do have the factors common, that is 3. So on solving, we get 16 upon 33. Now this is the maximum possible, or you can say the lowest form. So we leave the answer as it is, that is x is equal to 16 upon 33. That means the decimal we had 0.48 represented in the form of 16 by 33.